Sir Michael, when you look at the fact that this president is seemingly governing by extreme right-wing radio and TV, it has to be frightening to you as a Republican what happens to your party. And he sat in what he orchestrated, a live TV showdown with Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer, and said, I will own the shutdown. Put it on me. I will take a full credit or the weight of it. And now it's here, and he's blaming the Democrats of a shutdown that he said, it's mine. Give it to me.
Well, look, I mean, an overwhelming majority of every single legitimate poll that I have looked at does indicate that a vast majority of the American people do indeed blame Donald Trump and the Republican Party. From my vantage point, you know, the Republican Party has in many ways become a party based purely on fear, not a party that's based on empathy, not a party that's based on compassion. And that seems a bit hypocritical. I'm certain most people would agree when you think about the Republican Party being a party of moral values, Christian values. You're a pastor yourself, Reverend Sharpton. Certainly you would agree that nothing that we have seen thus far coming from this president is consistent with folks who would say they uphold the Bible, they uphold Christian truths. So from my perspective as a conservative, I'm extremely disappointed in this because, again, it is impacting people negatively, particularly people who are at the lower end of the economic spectrum. That does not benefit anyone, particularly many of the people who voted for Donald Trump himself. So I'm not certain how long he can continue holding out here. Democrats have no mandate whatsoever to work with him on this. And I do think if this continues to linger on, we will begin to see more Republicans in the Senate say, you know what, I have an election coming up. I cannot risk continuing to support this. We need to make a compromise and open up the government. And after all, Reverend Sharpton, why can't we open up the government and figure out a way to address immigration reform with something comprehensive?
Well, Chris, that's what they're saying. They're saying, let's give it a month. Let's open the government. We can work on this a month. He won't even accept that. And when you hear the point that's been raised by several on the panel about morality, not only are we ignoring the children that are being detained that Caitlin has written about and brought up tonight,